This video was sponsored by StudioPlugins.net. Hey, what's up? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a social media AR effect in Adobe After Effects. It's going to be a lot of fun where you can show off your work in a very unique way. So without further ado, let's open up Adobe After Effects and get started. All right, so here we are in Adobe After Effects. And what I have prepared for this tutorial is this green screen file, which I have already keyed out and then just replaced with a simple green solid. So it's easier to key on your end and also easier to set instead of with an alpha. So if you would like to go ahead and download this video file, you can do so with the link in the description below. Apart from that, I found this background image on pexels.com, and then I also went to my Instagram page and just took a few print screens of nice frames of videos that I had standing there. And another thing that we will use in this video is from Studio Plugins, and that's the AE Studio here. It allows you to browse motion presets, text presets, transitions, graphics and effects and sound effects all within After Effects. So once you're logged in, you can just literally browse in here, click on something, and then you would have sound effects, or if you would like to go and have some transitions here, or if you would like to have something very specific in a graphic effect. For example, you want some backgrounds. You go over here and you'll find a bunch of backgrounds. So a really cool plugin for Adobe After Effects, which we will be using to add a little bit of detail. So you don't really need it if you don't have it to follow along, but it's an amazing tool that I just wanted to cover in this video. And they also are today's video sponsor. All right, so now that we're in After Effects, let's get started. I'm going to drag in my green screen into a new composition right here. So what I will do is go to effects and then keying, apply the key light effect and just grab the color in the background. Then I'm going to bring in the pixels photo, and I'm also going to press F4 on the keyboard until I see these options right here, and I'm going to turn these two layers into 3D layers. Then I'm going to click on my pixels and I'm going to press P on the keyboard to reveal its position attributes, and I'm going to press here on the Z position and write in 5000, so I push it further back into Z space. Then I'm going to click here in the corners, hold shift, and then just drag it out so I get this to match the height of my scene. And now all I have done is I have myself here in 3D space or 2.5D space together with my background that is a little bit farther into space. So now when we're going to push in or move our camera, we're going to see a lot of parallax. For example, if I go now to my camera and I would move, you would see some parallax in the background, and it's not like it's just a static image behind me, and that's exactly what we want. So I'm going to undo that and then right click, create a new camera, and I'm going to make this camera into a 35 millimeter camera and then click OK. So now we see that it changed the view a little bit. So what we can do to compensate this is just bring the background a little bit closer, because in the end it's indoors and it shouldn't be that far into the background. If you want, you can also just bring the camera closer. So what I'll do now is right click new and create a new null object and turn this also into a 3D layer, and then click on my camera and parent that to the null. Then rename the null to camera control and then press P on the keyboard to click on the stopwatch here for creating a keyframe for your position attributes at the beginning of your timeline. Then I'm going to move all the way till the end of my track, and here I'm just going to push it in and push it up. We have a soft, subtle camera movement pushing in. And if you want, you can also reverse this animation by just selecting the two keyframes, right click, keyframe assistance, and time reverse. So there we go. So now we have something zooming out. Maybe that's a better idea when you're trying to reveal stuff around you. And now what we want to do is start adding in all our things. So what I will do is first open up my Instagram images folder and just bring all my images in here. And then I'm going to turn them into a 3D layer. And I'm also going to press S on the keyboard and just put them like at 30% because they're quite big. Then I'm going to select my first one and I'm just going to click on the rectangle tool here. And I'm just going to mask out whatever I want to see. So maybe I just want to see my work and then the bottom part right here. And there we go. And I'm just doing this roughly, but obviously if you want this to be perfect, go in Photoshop, make sure that you have nice images with a nice border around of it or something like that. That's going to be completely up to you. Obviously, this is just a proof of concept. So I'm going to copy my mask by hitting Ctrl C, and then selecting all of these images. And because I've just taken all these images at the same aspect ratio, I can just paste them. And normally that would just add a mask on all these images correctly. Maybe I'm off a little bit with the scroll, but that doesn't matter too much for my video. So now that I have this, I'm looking around of me. So what I want to do is press P on the keyboard for all of these images, and also make sure that they're 3D, and then click on an image. And all I want to do now is press V on the keyboard and then just push it and place it into position. So maybe I push it a little bit closer towards the camera. And then I'm also going to rotate it so it looks like it's all always facing me at all times. So we have to kind of think of where is it in Z space. Well, it's closer to us, so I'm going to pull back. This one is going to be further away, so I'm going to push it away by just increasing the Z here. And you can actually see that it's already behind of me, but just to keep things logical, because sometimes After Effects dares to glitch with this, I'm also going to put it behind my green screen. And if you want to make sure which is your footage, you can always change this to a yellow color. So now you can easily see where is your footage in your timeline. And so once you're satisfied with this look, what you can do now is select all of these and then press P on the keyboard and click on stopwatch, and then go back wherever they should be appearing. So like right here, I'm unlocking my phone, so I'm taking it out, opening it. So maybe starting from here, I'm going to right click on the position and then reset it. And so now they're all back into the center. And then I'm going to select these last keyframes, and a little bit later, I'm just going to make sure they pop up over like 1 second time. So that's around 30 frames. And I'm also going to press S, or hold shift and press S, so we also reveal the scale property, and then click on stopwatch for the scale. Move the scale all the way till the end, and then right here we're going to set it to 0. So now we have a scale up and a position up into position right here. We're also going to select all of these and just trim them to the moment they appear. So that way we can just visually see things a little bit easier. So now we have this animation of all these things appearing. If you want, you can always offset these, and that's going to turn everything organic. So that's going to make it a lot better. We can select all of the last keyframes from all of these layers, and then we're going to right click, keyframe assistance and easy ease. We're going into the graph editor and zoom in a little bit, and then take one of these arcs and just push them in a little bit so we get a nice slow stop. So maybe I should have verified the position for each, because they're actually starting up here. But we want them to start from the position of the phone, so you'll have to reposition them. You should have done that before offsetting them. That would have been a lot easier. You can do that together. But we can do that pretty quickly. Alright, so now that we have this, this is also something you could do with 3D camera tracked footage, and that could make it look really dynamic. All you would have to do here, if you want to place it behind you, is rotoscope yourself out. But now that we have our photos and everything going on, we want to add a little bit more detail, really spice it up, make it look like augmented reality, social media, holograms. So to do that, you will need to add in some likes or some follows and everything that has to do with social media. And what's really cool is that Studio Plugins actually has this in their Studio app. So you can actually browse all their presets and use these for this effect. If you want, you can also download the Studio app with link in the description below. I would highly encourage you to check it out. It works both for After Effects and Premiere Pro. So right here in After Effects, we will go to Window, Extensions, and add in the AE Studio. And right here we can now see an entire library of things that they provide with an After Effects, which is really convenient. So what we're going to concentrate on is the graphics effects. So I'm going to open up the social media. So I'm going to open up the shape elements and then go into the social media folder. I'm going to use these hearts. So I'm going to add these to my scene by clicking and adding them. I'm also going to add in the likes and everything in here. And then I'm also going to select just a regular like and add that into my scene. And we can also add in, for example, hashtag Instagram. Why not? If you want, you can even add in text messages or weather balloons, which is also really cool for the augmented reality stuff. And you can even animate it with some really cool lines to add in a little bit more spice, for example. So let's try that out. And so like this, you can see how easy it is to bring in things from AE Studio into After Effects with a click of a button, and boom, you have it in your system. So what you want to do here is just solo one, for example. And also I'm going to toggle the switches, turn these all into 3D layers. And so now we can, for example, reposition this a little bit closer to the camera, maybe press S on the keyboard and lower the scale quite a bit. This case, we can unsolo it so we can see where we want to place it. Maybe we want to make it look like this is the interaction of this photo. So we're going to bring it over a little bit. And then I'm going to double click on it so we can go into the controls. And we can change the green here to red and the pink to a more reddish pink. So we have a little bit of variation. But like this, you can also change the colors of all their elements. So everything that you import, you can also modify it, which is super useful. Then you can duplicate this if you want, offset it, and then go all the way over here. Maybe push it even closer to the camera. Why not? And like this, we will get some variation over the time. So the more different elements you bring in, the more time variation you add, the more randomization you're going to make the more organic it's going to look. Obviously, you don't have to exaggerate these things, but yeah, you get the idea. Then let's concentrate on this one. This is really cool. We have a pop-up here with all the followers. So what I want to do here is also scale it down to 50% so I can see what I am doing, or even 20. And then push it really close to the camera. There we go. And then we're going to rotate it towards myself so it's actually looking like it's interacting with me. And I'm going to push it a little bit like this. Okay. And then we can also jump back into social media. And this time we can, social icons. We can bring in some Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube, for example. And why not a WhatsApp, because I like the color difference here. And then we're also going to turn these into 3D layers and also push these pretty close to the camera and find us a nice spot. So maybe right here, it's a little bit empty. We can move them over here, place them over here. Can add in these film damages, which are also really cool. For example, I'm just going to show it on one of these. I'm going to add in this effect on top of it. We can just toggle the switches and set this to a Luma inverted matte. And now you can see that if we're going to play this, and I'm just going to solo this one so we can concentrate on that one, we can see some holographic glitch. So now if we also turn this into a 3D layer, press P on the keyboard for the WhatsApp image, or like the Instagram image, press hold shift for the R, and then copy these values and paste them to the glitch. Make sure that you delete the keyframes. But now you will get it like it's actually sticking on there. And you will get in some glitch effects. So that's also a really cool thing. You could even say that you want to rotate this horizontally so it looks more like a hologram. And there we go. Cool. So these are some tricks that you can apply. Then after that, I'm going to select all of these files or all these layers. Press F on the keyboard and just make sure that we remove the camera option here, and also our green screen. And for the rest, also our background. Set everything to screen. So this is just a test. If you don't want it, you can remove that, but it just adds a little bit more of a hologram feeling. And then we can also press T on the keyboard and set the opacity for all our layers to 85. And like that, we're going to get a little bit more of a see-through effect, and that's going to make it look even more holographic. So now what we need to do is add a adjustment layer on top of it all. This is going to be a little bit of a grade. And here we're going to apply a curves to it and also a tint and also Perfect Glow. Perfect Glow is a free preset that you can download on our website, but it gives you a nice glow to everything. So I'm going to just uncheck that for now. So now I'm going to also uncheck the tint. I'm first going to add a little bit of an S curve make sure that I don't go too dark and brighten up my highlights a little bit like that. Add in some tint for 30%, something like that. And then in, we're going to add Perfect Glow. Perfect Glow, I'm going to set the threshold to 85, so it's only going to look at the highlights. And I'm also going to increase the radius to something like 50. We can also play around a little bit with the intensity here until we find something that works. If you want very specific things to be glowy, you can always go to those things. And what I like to do here is add a solid composite effect to that and make sure that you have a black background. Now you can apply a perfect glow and you will see that it's going to look a lot better. And then what you can also do is on the background, I'm going to add a camera lens blur, set this to something like 15. So we get a little bit more depth of field in the background and also darken it just a little bit. And then for the camera, I'm going to press A twice and enable the depth of field and set the aperture to something like 50 or 100. See what works and make sure that the focus distance is correctly set at the depth of yourself so you don't appear blurry, but everything around you does according to depth of your scene. And then once you're satisfied with your entire animation, you can actually do sound effects as well, just straight out from the AE Studio. So if you go over to sound effects, you can find transitions here. So I'm going to add in this and this, and I'm also going to select these two, right click, time stretch, and stretch them to 250. So they're slower, and then I'm going to just offset them a little bit so we get some variations. And obviously you have to press L on the keyboard and lower the volume to something like minus 25. So it's very subtle, or minus 20. You can also add a low pass filter. Set it to low, copy this and paste it to all of your sound effects. And then you have a little bit more of a bassier touch to it. All right, and there we have it. That brings us to this final result. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also be sure to check out studioplugins.net with the link in the description below. Amazing tool for After Effects and Premiere Pro. And yeah, apart from that, I'm going to leave you with another video of mine right here so you can continue your VFX journey. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see more and hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, I'll see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.